If there was an airstrip or airdrome in Tesoro, more tourists would be flocking the area. This is the argument of local leaders here who believe visitors camp in neighboring Rwanda before coming to Mugahinga National Park. In Tesoro, trekking mountain gorillas is one of the major tourist activities. Leaders here believe that when Tesoro airdrome is developed, it will enable tourists to come directly to the western part of the country by plane. Abel Bizimana, the LC5 chairperson for Tesoro District, feels that the government has neglected the airdrome of Nyakabande, yet Tesoro Tourism contributes to the country's tourism sector.
They cannot even think about Tesoro, where millions and millions of dollars are collected every day for the country. So I don't know who is helping our country to prioritize. I don't know who is really making decisions for Uganda. This is not a matter of Tesoro. This is a matter of Uganda. This is a cash cow. More than 50% of mountain gorillas are here in Tesoro only. But look at the roads to Chimbiri. Look at the airfield. So I was of the view that it becomes emergency that this airfield is done.
Honorable Jameson Sababuturo, the Member of Parliament for Bufumbira East, notes that Tesoro is among the leading tourism districts in Uganda.
To become the power of Uganda in the real sense, we have to do a number of things. One is improvement of infrastructure. Infrastructure is very, very key to opening up Tesoro to the rest of the world. And by infrastructure, we are talking about roads, we are talking about airports, we are talking about medical facilities.
Developing the airdrome will help in boosting tourism and trade in Tesoro District. But what immediately worries leaders is also the reduced flights to Tesoro due to the bad state of the airdrome.
The good news is that now the process is underway to ensure that the expansion, modernization of our airdrome is clearly done. And I do believe that in the new year, we're going to see major changes, which are intended to upgrade the airdrome, give it a new status, and that will help us to get the tourists or visitors direct from source, instead of having them stopping at Entebbe or Kigali.
Nsababuturo reiterates the importance of developing facilities.
Before this, I think there was something that you had posed, that what is the key product in tourism for Tesoro. Definitely, Tesoro has one unique selling point, and these are the mountain gorillas. So the visitors who come to Tesoro, 97% of the visitors come for gorilla tourism. So gorilla tourism is number one, it's the key attractor, it's the one that attracts. But we have others that are accompany this gorilla tourism. We have the hiking of the mountains, we have the vatwa trail, we have the culture.
Richard Muneza, Tesoro District Tourism Officer, has asked the people to conserve the national park. He also requested people around national parks to desist from selling their land and property to investors, but instead always lease them.
Try and protect the natural resources we have, because the moment we tamper with the natural sources, even what I'm talking about, the tourism will go. The climate change has started affecting some of these features. So the moment we don't protect the natural sources, whatever we're planning social economically will go. Number two, definitely the peace must be observed. Let's always really try to create peace so that we can enjoy these other resources.
Currently, gorilla habituation permit is at $1,500 to tourists outside East Africa and $1,000 to those within East Africa. Story compiled by Kate Atuzalide for the news.